In this example, I'm going to join some core customer data with a data set that includes their first purchase date so that I have that field appended to the core customer data. I bring in the join tool and attach the core customer data to the left side marked with the L and the first purchase data to the right side. Whenever you bring in this tool, the first thing you need to do is configure how the join is going to happen. In this case, we have a customer ID field in both data sets. One is called customer ID, and the other is just called ID. So we can use this field from both data sets. As you can see here, the ID field can have different names, but as long as you are manually defining which fields to join together, then they will join if the same ID number exists in each of the data sets. Let's run the workflow to see the results. If we look closely at the join tool, we can see three outputs. The J represents the data that was joined together between the two sides. We can see the core customer data on the left and the first purchase data on the right. Notice how the ID field we used to join with is duplicated. Customer ID and ID. We can go back to the join tool and deselect it from the right side so it only comes through once. So deselect the ID field. And then we'll run the workflow again. Notice how the ID field is no longer shown in the final result. If we take a look at the data coming out of the L side, this is the data from the left input that did not join to the right input. Because we were joining on that customer ID field and the ID field, this one record with an ID of 456 does not exist in the data coming in from the right side. We have 6 unique IDs coming in from the left and 5 unique IDs coming in from the right. So the result is 5 records joined with 1 record unjoined on the left. If we look at the right side output, we see no records there. All of the input records from the right side join to the left. It's important to be able to see what does not join in your data because this can help identify missing records, dirty data, or other issues.